The GasGas is one of the coolest looking bikes in the pits. I love the red. I love the simplicity of it. This bike is just no nonsense, right? There's no bells and whistles, there's no map switches, there's no traction control, there's no quick shift, none of that stuff. Get on the bike and ride it. What you see is what you get. Hey, I was surprised at how good the power was. You know, the air box on the GasGas is closed up a little bit more than the other Austrian brands intentionally. They wanna make a different power delivery. I was pretty impressed with how good the power was. Very long, very broad, very linear delivery, very friendly delivery. I think that this is a great bike for a kid coming off of a mini bike. One of the things that GasGas really aims for is comfort. You know, and the fork clamps, the fork clamps offer more flex than the other two Austrian brands. The suspension settings are European based, which are typically a lot softer, smoother. So when you get on the GasGas, it's all about plushness. This thing is comfortable, it's smooth. For somebody like myself, already big for a 250, I want a more substantial suspension feel. But if I'm riding 70%, man, it doesn't get much more comfortable than the GasGas. The thing is really, really fun to ride. Very comfortable. If you're looking for comfort, you're looking for plushness, you're looking for a front end that's really compliant with that fork clamp and a smooth power delivery, the GasGas is what you're looking for.
The GasGas MC250F, super fun bike, right? It's like if you're old enough to remember plain wrap products at the grocery store like I am, like you go to this market and it's just paper towels with a blue stripe, it says paper towels. Nothing fancy, it just works, right? It's good. The GasGas is dirt bike. It's a good bike. It does nothing wrong, it just doesn't do anything great. There's a lot of potential there. I think the only shortcomings for the GasGas are the suspension is a little soft, but it's super comfortable. Like when you're not like really a fast guy, which I'm not, it's comfortable, it's trustworthy, but it does have a lot of pitch fore and aft. Not the fastest bike, definitely not the worst power band. The only thing that I don't like about it are the handlebars. They're just kind of funky and they have a strange feel when you're riding, and they're silver chrome and they're not that cool.
The GasGas is, it's a fun bike. It's kind of like the Cowie where it does everything really good, but it's just kind of basic. Like it's just basic out of all the other bikes or out of the other Austrian bikes, which is kind of the purpose of that brand anyway. So it's kind of unfair, I guess, to compare it to say the KTM, which is their ready to race model. But if you're a intermediate rider, I mean, I think the GasGas is a great bike for you. I thought it revved really well. I thought it was a little bit faster than the Husky. It's just basically everything's kind of toned down on it, like the suspension's softer and power's a little less than the KTM. So it's kind of just basic. I don't know how else to put it, but it feels really good. It's smooth. You can trust it. So it's nothing special, but just a solid dirt bike.
Since the Austrian group introduced the GasGas, I've spent quite a bit of time on various models, whether it's the MC450, MC250, or whatnot, and this bike always impresses me. It's supposed to be the entry-level bike from the Austrian group. It's a little bit cheaper, doesn't have a map switch, silver bars, silver wheels, stuff like that, but dude, this bike's so playful, it's so fun. It's definitely softer, so think about that if you're in the market for one, if you're a heavier guy or whatnot. But because it's soft, it's very compliant. I weigh about 155 and I didn't have any issues today. The front end wasn't too soft. The rear end felt fine. Again, the air fork impressed me. I didn't really notice too much other than sometimes I overjumped some stuff. The motor was good. It's kind of crazy that you can save so much money on this bike and still go to like AEO Power Sports and get the map switch for just a couple hundred bucks, and then you have a map switch on this bike. So definitely cool to think about if you're in the market for a GasGas.
was a little bit softer for me. The suspension was a little bit softer. It was kind of more of a preference thing. And the other thing is it didn't have, it didn't quite have the bells and whistles. So I kind of think for me, that kind of like, okay, if I'm gonna go buy something, you know, I'm just gonna spend maybe a little extra money and get it. It wasn't, like I said, it wasn't bad. It was kind of more like off-roady feeling maybe. But I will say that the GasGas, I thought maybe turned better than the Husky or the KTM. It had a little bit better feel in it as far as, you know, maybe, and I did see maybe it had different triple clamps, so you could feel some differences. So I could see how people, some guys might like that. For me, it just felt like it was a little bit too slow. And for, you know, for a few reasons like that, and a little bit like soft, like I wanted something a little stiffer. That's kind of why I put the couple of other Austria bikes a little higher. So it's at the bottom, but I think that's kind of more preference. I couldn't get away from the KTM, the power and the way I could move around on the Husky on the track, the way it stuck the ground with traction and stuff. So it was just kind of more like a preference thing. That's why it's probably a little lower on my list.
For the GasGas MC250, I really enjoyed the tracking. On the bike, I didn't feel a lot of slipping on the track. It stayed planted in and out of the turns, coming out of the turns. We're at Paula, so it's pretty slick, and it stayed in its line. Also on the GasGas, the only thing I didn't really enjoy was the handlebars. I felt they were a little straight. I kind of like the more sweep back kind of bend. We'll be right back.